Hello everyone, 700 Apache here, and in this video I'm going to show you how to turn an inflatable sprinkler into a normal inflatable. For an example, this inflatable ball sprinkler I reviewed in my previous video appeared to be defective because that one sprayer right over there, yes that one right there, does not work. It doesn't spray when the hose is turned on and while it's also plugged in. Those other two do work, however still that's not enough to make me want to keep this as a sprinkler. Also, if you're going to be doing this with, like, a different type of inflatable sprinkler, like an animal, then you only need to do, like, these patch steps only two times. What I'm going to be using, that vinyl with the squares on it will be the inner layer for patching. That pink vinyl will be the outer layer for the patch. I'm also going to be using liquid vinyl cement, and I'm also going to be using a pair of scissors to work on this. Also, yeah, as you see, I'm about to cut open four holes. I'm about to cut open the holes from the three sprayers and where you plug the hose in. Again, if you're doing this with an inflatable animal, like a big mouth inflatable sprinkler, then you only need to, like, cut two holes because that one only has one sprayer. This one has three. Anyways, as you can see, I'm cutting around the sprayers of the inflatable. If you guys take a look very deeply, you can see there's a ring around the sprayer. I cut around that ring with the scissors, and I do this with every side, all three sprayers, and where you plug the hose in. I'm also going to show you why this sprinkler was defective, why only two of the sprayers were working, and why one wasn't. This is recorded on the same day when I was reviewing the product. And because of that, you can see that the tubes are still wet. It travels up that big tube right there and goes out the three, or should I say two, of those small tubes. Those two that I'm currently holding, those had still had water in them, so those are the ones that worked. While the other one, that one right there, does not work. When I cut open the tubes, I found out why that one side wasn't working. As you can also see, there's a fourth area where there's a closed tube. That one actually had an open hole. However, that one was sealed shut. The one right next to it was sealed shut. The one with the broken sprayer, where the non-functioning sprayer was sealed shut. I don't know why, but for some reason, the manufacturers kind of messed up. I don't know what they were thinking. Anyways, so yeah, that's why that one side wasn't working. Alright, what I do next is that I lay the ball out flat to which hole I am going to patch first. Yeah, again, I'm trying to lay it as flat as I can. What I do next is that I start off with the inner layer vinyl. I start cutting a big piece of it, and then I get it prepared by putting it inside. You don't want it too big, or else it'll be very difficult to put inside. You don't want it too small either, or else it won't patch correctly. After that, I get some of the pink vinyl, which will be the outer layer of the patching, and then after I cut off a piece, I start cutting a circle. One that I am more comfortable with. You don't want it too big or too small. So you want to measure it out as even as possible. So once I'm finally comfortable with the layers of vinyl I'm going to use, I start off with the inner layer by putting it inside the hole and start laying it flat in the inside of the beach ball. I also straighten it out correctly. I want to make sure that the hole is completely underneath it. Or else, when you put the glue on and try to patch it, the ball will stick on the other side of the ball from the inside out. So, what I do next is that I put some liquid vinyl cement on both on top of the inner patch and on the sides of the hole. Be a little bit careful when you put it on the inner patch, or else the inner patch can move around. as you can see, I'm trying to readjust it because it moved. I want to make sure, you know, it's in the right place. I then continue putting extra liquid vinyl cement, I mean, more on the edges, and then I start pressing the outer layer patch on top. I press it down as many times as I need to make sure that it is on correctly. You'll want to do this as many times as you need to. Once I'm comfortable enough, this next step is optional. You don't really have to do this, but as you can see, I'm trimming off a bit of some extra excess vinyl. What I do next, after I'm done cutting them, what I actually do next, what you really need to do next is, well, very simple. Once I'm comfortable with what I have, I start getting some liquid vinyl cement prepared, and I start putting it underneath the outer patch, ones that are not attached or glued on to the ball. Be a little bit careful, as the liquid vinyl cement can easily thin and can make the vinyl very thin and kind of flimsy at the same time. This can sometimes cause back folds on the extra vinyl. You don't need to worry about those. If you got like some very small back folds, I'll show you later in the video. Those can be dealt with. That's what the final step is for, which we'll get to next. So as you can see, I try to cover up as much sides as I can. I mean, I try to put glue on every side of the bottom of the patch where it has not been glued. Also keep a spare towel close by, because some of the liquid vinyl will get on your fingers when you start pressing the sides down. I press them down as many times as I need to make sure that it is completely connected. As you can see, I do it all around the patch. I also accidentally got a bit of some back folds, whereas where like the patch kind of bends a little bit by the tip of the edge, as you can kind of see on that left side. There's no need to worry. If you actually get some of these folds, that's what the final step is for. Even if you don't get any of these problems, I still recommend you do this final step. What I do on the final step, I cover each side of the patch, all around on the side of the patch, I cover it with liquid vinyl cement to make sure that it is completely sealed. And after doing these steps over and over again, making sure that I have enough liquid vinyl cement, later on, once it's all dry, I do the exact same thing on every other hole on the ball. And as you can see right now, this once ball sprinkler is now a big, beautiful beach ball. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you folks next time.